S-Chan presents educational video lectures as per the AICTE curriculum. Difficult concepts made easy. Study anywhere, anytime.
So, dear students, in the previous video, we discussed about the basics of writing, basics and essentials of sensible writing. We discussed about the different kinds of writing, expository, narrative, and so on. And how do we make a good introduction and conclusion in any piece of writing? So, in this part of the video, we are going to discuss in detail about what is a comprehension, what is précis, and what is an essay, what are the differences technically in all three of them, and how do we make sure that we are impactful and good in terms of writing all three of them. So we'll understand the basics in terms of the differences, and we'll also try to, you know, understand how do we write all three of them. Hello students, welcome to S-Chand Academy. I'm Dr. Vidushi Bhardwaj. If you wish to learn more about vocabulary building, sentence construction, all the technicalities of grammar, reading comprehension, parts of speech, sentence construction, you may refer to English for Engineers, which is a wonderful book which will cover all the aspects we have already discussed. And of course, the book has a lot of examples where you can practice, and this will help you improve your vocabulary as well. The ebook link of this book has been given in the description box. You can refer to it. So, moving ahead with the comprehension, first of all, let us understand what you mean by reading comprehension. Now, this is the most basic activity which students are given at their college level, and even starting from the school level, you must have been given lot many exercises on reading comprehension. What is the purpose? What is the meaning of reading comprehension? And how do we make sure that we are impactful here? So, reading comprehension is an active or interactive process that occurs before, during, and after a person reads a particular piece of writing. So, technically speaking, there is one paragraph which is given to you, which you try to read, understand, and there are a few questions given at the end of the paragraph, so that the one who's assessing you would know whether you have been able to comprehend this passage or not. Now, let me be very clear on one thing here. There is a lot of difference between understanding and comprehending. You may be able to understand the language well, but you may not be able to comprehend the meaning behind the words given in the passage. So, if I say I understand Punjabi, but I do not comprehend the meaning of Amrita Pritam's poems. So, understanding language and comprehending the gist of the passage are two different things altogether, which we need to understand. So, any reading comprehension activity is a pillar of the act of reading. So, there are different ways how do we do that? What are the different categories or kinds of comprehension, reading comprehension? That is something we should understand. There are two elements that make up the process of reading comprehension. Now, what are those elements? Number one, vocabulary knowledge and text comprehension. So, in order to understand the text, you must be able to understand the language, the vocabulary, and the meaning behind the written words. Now, moving ahead, there are different types of reading comprehension. The first is literal. The second is inferential. The third one is critical. And of course, these three we are not able to achieve because of certain weaknesses in our personality or character that we'll also talk about a little later. But moving again back to the first category, which is literal comprehension. So, literal, as the name suggests, comprehension, literal comprehension is something which we are trying to understand what the author literally wants to say. So, anything which is written there in the comprehension, would mean the same, literally. So, the reader needs to understand the ideas and information clearly stated in the reading material. It will involve a lot of facts, a lot of, supporting details, outlining, summarizing, and information which is used to supply meaning, some specific direction, some sequence, and of course, explicit details about the topic will be a part of your reading comprehension content. So, for example, some of the questions which can be given after literal piece of reading comprehension could be that what words state the main idea of the story. So, after every reading comprehension, you will find a few questions given at the end of the comprehension, which is a usual style, so that the readers could know that what have you understand through the passage or the comprehension. So, in literal comprehension, you may have certain questions like outlining the first paragraph of the story, what happened first, what was the sequence of the story, what meaning do you find in the story. So, literally what is there in the idea, you need to just give your answers based on the literal meaning of the comprehension. There is no hidden meaning, that means. So, it's all factual. The second kind is very important, which is inferential. And inferential would mean, you know, taking out inferences. So, something which may not be there clearly in the passage, but you may have to take out hints and inferences from the passage, will be a part of inferential comprehension. It deals with what the author means by what is said. So, you have to read between the lines. You have to read carefully. You may not be able to find out the meaning right in the first go. You may have to go back and read again. Of course, yes, the meanings could be many. You have to draw out inferences. So, these inferences are made in main idea, supporting details, sequence, cause and effect, relationships. So, it could also involve interpreting some figurative language, some figure of speech if it is a literary passage, some kind of literary devices if it is a poem, and of course, drawing conclusions, predicting outcomes, determining the mood and judging the author's point of view. And most importantly, these inferential passages are the ones which are used in literary pieces of writing. So, if it's a novel or a poem or some kind of lines in the passage or in the poems itself where the poet, you know, is not very, you may not understand the meaning, you know, right in the first go. So, you have to read between the lines, you have to understand the context, you have to try to find out what the poet is trying to say, and then, you know, taking out the inferences. And the most important questions which could be asked in comprehension, which is inferential comprehension, is what is the theme? So, it may be a sad theme, it may be a melancholy, it may be very happy theme, or the poet is trying to explore something, or probably somebody has died, you know, in the poet's family. It depends, you know, what is the theme. What effect does this character or event have on the story? How do you think the story will end? So, these kind of questions give you a lot of room for creativity. If you have understood this passage, inferential passage, well, if you have understood these lines, then of course, you can write your answers in your own creative way, because it's a very subjective kind of writing. It's not, you know, it's not an objective writing. So, here, how do you think the story will end? You'll have to find out how do you think it will end. So, that may not sound same with somebody else's answer. So, it's very, very personal. Then we have critical comprehension. So, critical comprehension is to do with the critical analysis, some kind of understanding where you need to apply your critical thinking, some kind of, you know, where the reader has to use some external criteria from his or her own experience in order to evaluate the quality, values of writing, author's reasoning, simplifications, and generalizations. So, the reader may act, you know, react, I would say, emotionally and intellectually with the material, because everybody's life experiences are different. Answers to some of the following questions will vary. Now, whenever there is a critical comprehension, we have to understand that there is nothing clear in the comprehension. So, for example, critically evaluate this essay. What do you think? You know, what could possibly happen after this particular incident? So, what is your view, or is your argument logical? So, you will have to apply your critical thinking skills here, where there is nothing, purely black or white. It has to be a logical, again, thinking, but you have to think about all the alternatives. You'll have to think about, keeping your biases away, but again, thinking from the point of view that, yes, whether this is good or that is good. So there's nothing like you have to keep your biases away in these kind of essays or in this kind of comprehension. So to conclude, literal, inferential, and critical comprehensive reading is what makes a skilled, strong reader. Each one is equally important. In order to practice, you have to go through these pieces of writing first. This skill has to be developed. It does not happen in a day. So how to achieve this now? So read newspapers, try to assess, try to evaluate the piece of, headlines. Critical thinking is most importantly used in news analysis. So if you get a very important news headline today, which is to do with probably the economy of India or layoffs in the private sector, use your critical thinking skills as to if the people are being laid off, there are companies who are also employing. So this is known as critical thinking. Instead of flowing in one direction, you have to apply your mind. So let us see certain examples here now. Now, what are the reasons for poor reading comprehension? That is what we should know first. There are different reasons why, at times the students and even the most grown-up people do not understand the comprehension. What could be the reasons? So there are a variety of reasons. For example, I may have a decoding deficiency. So that means I may have difficulty in gaining some kind of understanding from the passage for different reasons. The reasons could be many. Number one, my vocabulary is not appropriate level. I have not got the knowledge base of the area. I have very limited knowledge base. Or I may not have some kind of, attention towards the topic. I may be attention deficit and so on. So these are the reasons why some people are not able to comprehend well. And we have to make sure that we overcome these difficulties, which can be done only by practice again. We can definitely improve the knowledge base by reading. Reading helps, especially the newspaper articles. And in fact, listening to others' views and opinions and improving vocabulary will help us in achieving success in terms of reading comprehension effectively. So look at this exercise. It's a very small comprehension passage which I have put here. So I can read out, the city was bustling with activity as people rushed about with their own purposes and destinations. In the kiosk, I found a small park where I could sit and watch the world go by. The green grass and tall trees provided a welcome respite from the concrete jungle, and I felt my stress and anxiety melt away as I listened to the birds chirping in the branches above. Now, it's a very small, short paragraph. What is the setting of the passage? What does the protagonist do in the city? What is the purpose of the small park for the protagonist? And how does the protagonist feel as they sit in the park? Now, you have to understand what kind of a reading comprehension passage it is. Is it literal? Is it inferential? Or is it critical? Okay, and try to answer these questions. So definitely it's something which is there in the passage which you have to find, and these, solving these answers will help you improve your comprehension skills. So another passage, which is the effects of air pollution on human health. This is again a literal comprehension passage because it's all about the facts and what air pollution is doing to all of us. It's all about that. So with this, we end the part one, where we discussed about the comprehension passages in detail, what do you mean by reading comprehension, and what are the reasons why some people are not able to comprehend very clearly, what are the different kinds of reading comprehension passages, and how to improve our reading comprehension skills. In part two of the video, we'll discuss about the Précis writing. What is a Précis and how is it different from comprehension and essay? That also you will get to know, and how to achieve effectiveness in writing Précis. is something we are going to discuss. If you wish to learn more about vocabulary building, sentence construction, all the technicalities of grammar, reading comprehension, parts of speech, sentence construction, you may refer to English for Engineers, which is a wonderful book which will cover all the aspects we have already discussed. And of course, the book has a lot of examples where you can practice, and this will help you improve your vocabulary as well. The ebook link of this book has been given in the description box. You can refer to it. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell to get updates about the future videos.
All rights reserved. This video has been prepared for educational purposes only. No part of it may be reproduced or copied without the permission of the copyright holder.